Hello friends, welcome to 1 minute GK. In this video, I bring to you the part first of 4th chapter of 9th geography NCERT, that is climate. Let's see the topics in this chapter. Introduction of climate and weather. Climatic controls. Factors affecting India's climate. The Indian monsoon. The onset of monsoon and withdrawal. The seasons. Distribution of rainfall. And monsoon as a unifying one. Friends, in the part first, I will cover the first four topics. So, introduction. Climate refers to the sum total of weather conditions and variations over a large area for a long period of time. The time usually is more than 30 years. So, climate is a long time idea. Whereas weather refers to the state of the atmosphere over an area at any point of time. It could be 2 hours, it could be 1 day, it could be a week. So, climate is a long-term idea, while the weather is short-term idea. The world is divided into a number of climatic regions. The climate of India is mainly described as the climate of monsoon type. So, the elements of climate and weather. The elements of both climate and weather are same. Those are 5. Temperature, atmospheric pressure, wind, humidity and precipitation. Friends, the temperature is nothing but degree of hotness or coldness of a body. Atmospheric pressure is nothing but the pressure that is exerted by the atmosphere on us, and it is usually taken as 1 atmosphere or 1.01325 bars. Third element is wind. The flowing air is nothing but wind. Humidity. The amount of water vapors present in the air is termed as humidity. And the last is precipitation. It could be anything that is falling from the clouds in the sky. It includes snowfall, the rainfall, and the devastating hails. So let's see some basics, because geography is a semi-scientific subject, and in the chapter of climate, there are some terms. So before going to see that, we should have some basics. First is latitudes. Latitudes are nothing but the horizontal imaginary lines on the Earth globe. They explain the position of the particular area as north to south from equator. Friends, the equator is 0 degree latitude. It is in the center of Earth globe. Longitudes. The longitudes are nothing but the vertical imaginary lines. They indicate the position of that particular area as east to west from Greenwich Meridian. The Greenwich Meridian is nothing but GMT. It is considered as 0 degree latitude. Third is altitude. The altitude is nothing but the height from the sea level. Direction of wind. It is always from high pressure to low pressure. Always remember, the direction of wind will be always from high pressure to low pressure. In summer, the mainland India has low pressure and high temperature. And in winter, the mainland India has high pressure and low temperature. So just remember, the pressure and temperature will be contradictory. Means, when the mainland India will have low pressure, the temperature of it will be higher, and vice versa. So let's see the climatic controls. There are 6 major climatic controls that define the climate of any place. The first is latitude. The temperature decreases from equator to poles as one moves from equator to poles. This is due to the slanting of the solar radiation or the solar waves. Second is altitude. Altitude is nothing but the height. And as one move upwards to higher altitudes, the temperature gets decreased. In general, for 160 meters of height, the temperature decreases by 1 degree Celsius. Third is pressure and wind system. The pressure and wind system also impacts the rainfall and temperature. You may always come across the news like there is a low pressure area created in the Bay of Bengal. And as it gets intensified, the rainfall will increase. So, this is that phenomenon. Fourth, the distance from the sea. It is also termed as continentality. The seas have moderating influence on the near area. For example, the places on the coastal regions like Mumbai and Chennai will not experience the changes in the day and night temperature very much. But the places in the mainland India, which are away from sea like Delhi or Jaipur, they will experience the very sharp changes in the day and night temperatures, or the changes in the temperature of summer and winter. Fifth, the ocean currents. There are two types of ocean currents, that are cold and hot currents. They also impact the climate of that region. Finally is the relief features. The relief features are kind of barrier like mountains and hills, and they also impact the climate of that region. So the factors affecting India's climate. First factor is latitude. The Tropic of Cancer, that is 23.5 degree north latitude, which passes through the middle of country from Gujarat in the west to the Mizoram in the east. Friends, this Tropic of Cancer passes through 8 states of India. Those are from west to east: Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Tripura and Mizoram. The areas lying south to it is known as tropical, while as the area lying north to it is subtropical. Therefore, India's climate has characteristics of both tropical as well as subtropical. You can clear this idea from the adjacent image. Altitude. India has mountains to the north. We know that the Himalayan mountains are present over the northern states and the north boundary of India, including India, Nepal and Bhutan as well. Those mountains to the north has an average height of about 6000 meters or 6 kilometers. India also has a coastal region having average height just 30 meters. So you can see in the adjacent figure that in the north you will get the colors like white and red, whereas in the coastal area you will get the colors like green. So the coastal area has very less height, average height, that is of 30 meters. The Himalayas prevent the cold winds coming from Central Asia from entering the Indian subcontinent. They are protecting us. The Himalayas are nothing but the barrier which is created by Mother Nature to take care of mainland India. It is because of these mountains that this subcontinent experiences comparatively milder winters than the Central Asia. Pressure and winds. There are three components: pressure and surface wind, upper air circulation and western cyclonic disturbances and tropical cyclones. So first, the pressure and surface winds. The pressure and wind conditions over India are very unique. During winters, there is high pressure area north of the Himalayas. So the area having high pressure area will have the low temperatures. Cold dry winds blow from this region to the low pressure areas over the oceans to the south. Yes, in general, the wind will flow from high pressure to low pressure area. Whereas in summer, the condition will be reverse. There is a low pressure area develops over interior Asia as well as in the northwestern India. Hence, the air moves in reverse direction, that is from south to north, means from oceans to mainland India. These winds blow over the ocean. Hence, they take the moisture with them and bring the widespread rainfall over the mainland India, and which is termed as monsoon. Second, the upper air circulation. The higher level of atmosphere is dominated by westerly flow, means the winds will coming from western direction. An important component of this flow is the jet stream. Friends, this jet stream are present over the altitude of 12 kilometers or 12,000 meters from the earth's surface. The jet stream are a narrow belt of high altitude westerly winds in the troposphere. These jet streams are located approximately over the 27 to 30 degrees north latitude, means they are present over the north of Tropic of Cancer. The third factor is western cyclonic disturbances and tropical cyclones. The western disturbances which enter the Indian subcontinent from the west and the northwest during the winter months originate over the Mediterranean Sea and are brought to India by westerly jet stream. Friends, this Mediterranean Sea is near the boundary of Africa continent and Europe continent, and which is in western direction to India. The tropical cyclones originate over the Bay of Bengal and the Indian Ocean. The tropical cyclones occur during the monsoons as well as in October and November. And they are part of the easterly flows, means they are coming from east, whereas the western cyclonic disturbances coming from west, from the Mediterranean Sea. The Indian monsoon. This is my favorite topic. Just because of this phenomena, the life on the Indian subcontinent is faster from the past. Monsoon are seasonal winds which reverse their direction of flow with the change of season. The climate of India is strongly influenced by the monsoon winds. So we will see the factors that affect the mechanism of Indian monsoon. First, the differential heating and cooling of land and water. Friends, the specific heat carrying capacity of land and water is different. The shifting of intertropical convergence zones, that is ITCZ, that is shifted over the Ganga plain during the summers. Two kinds of winds will converge or come towards each other. The intensity and position of high pressure areas towards the east of Madagascar, approximately as 20 degrees south over the Indian Ocean, affects the Indian monsoon. So let us see where the Madagascar is. This is the world map. We have talked about the Mediterranean Sea. It is between the Europe and Africa. And from that Mediterranean Sea, the western disturbances will come towards India. So this is Madagascar in the Indian Ocean, the island to the east of Africa. In yellow color you can see. The heating up of Tibetan Plateau in summers create low pressure area above the plateau. You can see the Tibet, which is in China, north of India. And the heating in the Tibet creates low pressure area. So the winds will come from ocean, that is high pressure area, to low pressure area of Tibet and give widespread rainfall in the Indian subcontinent. The movement of the Western Ridge Stream to the north of Himalaya and the presence of tropical Eastern Ridge Stream over the Indian Peninsula during summer also affect the Indian monsoon. So there is one topic called as Southern Oscillation, and it impacts monsoon in a very large way at a certain year between 2 to 5 years. So before going to Southern Oscillation, let's just see some geographical places. So comes toward the south, to the west of it, there is a coast called as Peruvian coast. It will be important while understanding the Southern Oscillation. Also, look, this is the Australia. Australia has Indian Ocean to the west, while on the east it has Pacific Ocean. So let's start the Southern Oscillation. The pressure conditions over the Southern Oceans also affect the monsoons. Normally, when the tropical eastern South Pacific Ocean experiences high pressure, means that region will have low temperature. The tropical eastern Indian Ocean experiences low pressure, means that will have high temperature. But in certain years, there is a reversal in pressure conditions. This periodic change in the pressure condition is known as Southern Oscillation. And due to these conditions, on certain year, India suffers from drought. And the reason for India to suffer from drought is termed as El Nino. So let us see what is El Nino is. It is a phenomenon in which a warm ocean current that flows past the Peruvian coast in place of cold Peruvian current. So look at this Peruvian coast. In the normal year, the Peruvian coast will have colder ocean currents. But when the El Nino is in operation, the coast will experience a warm ocean current. And that will happen in every 2 to 5 years. This phenomenon, hence also known as ENSO, that is El Nino Southern Oscillation. So let's see the El Nino from this figure. Look at the map of South America. To the west, it has Peruvian coast. And during the normal year, it will have the cold ocean current along the Peruvian coast. So it is given in the, whereas the region of Australia will have warm ocean current. But in the El Nino year, the Peruvian coast have the warm current instead of cold current. That's why it is given in warm in the second diagram. And so it will impact the Indian monsoon, and India will receive less precipitation than the average year. The rest part will be covered in the part 2. Thank you guys. Do like, share and subscribe. If you have any suggestion, please drop that into the comment box. Thank you.